What's happening, YouTube? I'm Scream.
And I am Binger.
I'm Artwork.
And we are...
Magnetic Man. And this is our takeover.
We picked this video. We picked a video for each of us. Real Arthur Smith, Real Oliver Jones, and something to do with Binger.
Didn't actually meet him at Glastonbury, didn't he nick his mask?
No, he nicked my mask. I went up to buy a mask, and the fella said, "Oh no, the one that's perfect for you, mate, Arthur Smith, the geezer just had it." And I went, "Oh, Arthur Smith." And he went,
"Glastonbury."
True to my roots, not really. I'm not Kenyan, by the way. Benga music was around a long time before I was even Benga, and it's an African style of music which consists of, it's called a mandarin.
Yeah.
The craziest rhythms, like if you actually listen to the rhythm, it's like...
Upside down bass.
Yeah, upside down bass.
We just wanted to show people where it actually started, because there's a lot of controversy about where dubstep started, so this is...
That song was made in Big Apple Records in the 60s.
Yeah.
I think it was actually between 1955 and 1956.
Yeah, yeah. Stockhausen, hope you enjoy.
Yeah, big up, dude. Ugh, Vince Clarke, the king of synthesizers. He, I've always wanted to go to his Temple synths, and in the video you can actually see why. He's just got the maddest patched synth sequences around. He's a bad boy.
He's got a plastic brain. This is Hatcher TV. This is a clip from Hatcher TV, which is a YouTube channel which actually features our hero,
DJ Hatcher.
DJ Hatcher. He used to work behind the counter of Big Apple Records, and he was basically a big driving force behind early dubstep music.
So Hatch, we've done this one for you just to let a few more people, show a few more people your hosting skills.
Big Apple clip is a little clip from an advert from Big Apple back in the day with Dirty Dougs, and it just shows you a little bit of rare footage of inside Apple Records.
And of when Hatcher had full fringe as well.
Yeah, and Rowdy Chops.
And Rowdy Chops dub.
We proper put him in there, didn't we?
Yep.
Yeah.
Your energy
when you touched me. Wow. That's classic piece of funk shizzle right there.
That is such a big tune. That's the soundtrack to our lives, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Soundtrack to my childhood.
And when we're on tour, it's Roger and Zap in the band.
It's actually a van as well, because it's not a tour bus, we just travel around in transit.
Yeah.
On the floor.
On the floor. No, SpongeBob was one of the biggest, it was the biggest track for quite a while. 2007, and it was just, I don't think anyone at the point had heard anything like it, and still now if you listen to it, you hear something new every time.
It holds up now.
Coke is a genius. Koki is a genius.
Legend.
So, YouTubers type in Koki on the little search engine up here, I think it'll be somewhere.
No, it's just over a bit. When you touch me, lifted me up. The Rave Tune video was just something that made us laugh because it was just a bit weird. It's like a team of archaeologists going looking at old rave stuff and just have a look. This is just a video that made us laugh and just shows you what you can do with auto-tune and technology nowadays. I've watched it quite a few times and I can't get the song out of my head, so have a little look.
Is it better than Chubby Rain?
Yeah.
Chocolate Rain.
Chocolate Rain, that's the one.
David Rodigan is not my dad, but David Rodigan, I wish, was my dad. The geezer is a complete legend, and he's a guy who went out to Jamaica and just learnt his craft, and now he's still one of the best DJs in the world. And
tearing up youth.
Tearing up some young bloods out in Antigua.
But he's nice about it as well. If you watch it, he's like...
Yeah.
Apologises for what he's about to do with the next tune, and just like demolishes him.
Start with that. I think it's one of our best shows of 2000.
One of the highlights of the tours of so far, the story so far. It's like a chapter.
It just shows you how good our shows are.
Yeah.
Glad to say that.
Yeah.
Right into Tokyo.
There isn't a video for that actually, but you're gonna hear the music.
Close your eyes, you'll see a video.
Yeah, okay. I'll describe what I see in my head when I close my eyes flying to Tokyo. I see little colours of blue.
So I see orange.
Alright.
From the xylophone.
And then we, I can see us in the sky.
Flying in.
Yeah, but wings, not a plane.
Real wings.
Real wings. I don't know if it's angel wings.
Getting Nowhere is a track that is a collaboration with John Legend, and it was a bit of a shocker when we got it back and how good it was and how much soul he put into the actual record. So it's yeah, it's one of my favourites off the album, and I hope you like it.
My mum likes Ping Pong, so
my mum actually thinks it should be number one.
Really?
Yeah.
She's right about most
she said,
things as well.
Said if it's not being released as a single, someone needs to be in trouble.
Fire, featuring Miss Dynamite. That's one you can take your top off to and raving in your house if you feel like it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna oblige.
Yeah, well, it depends who's in.
Feel it, but,
yeah, it's gonna smash up quite a few dancers over the next coming months.
We're ready for that, right?
And her voice is just like unmistakable. She is so good.
Blinding.
Yeah, and she's just amazing to work with. It's effortless for her. So.